I'm so happy to be reunited with a fat boy after 10 days.
This is one of my favorite sweet shops.
कुलर में देना, छोटा कुलर देना मेरे को, आठ देना, आठ
नॉलेन कोर्ट चार देना.
There she is.
My first ride where I'm not wearing my riding jacket. I'm gonna say a prayer and then start. The motorcycle feels super smooth. So looking at the bill today, some of you might wonder, does it cost 20,000 rupees each time I send the motorcycle for servicing?
Many a times we look to things that we don't have, things that we aspire to, that we look down upon, that we overlook what we have.
Boy, I just love this. The mishti dohi in the kullad, the earthen pot.
Hi right, folks, I have my helmet and I'm sitting in a cab that can only mean one thing. I'm going to pick up my motorcycle from service. It's about 10 days from the point that you saw me drop the motorcycle for service. So the problem that I faced was with regards to one of the components on the motorcycle, which they had to replace and they didn't have in stock. And that was my front brake pad. So in the earlier part of the video, I think I've talked about the rear brake pad, but actually it was the front brake pad that needed to be replaced. And so I got a call from them saying that I can do about 500 kilometers on it. 500 kilometers is roughly about a couple of rides. And I didn't want to go through the whole hassle of collecting the motorcycle and then dropping it back in less than a month. So I said, please try and source the brake pad. I will wait till you source it. So long story short, the motorcycle has been at the showroom for the last 10 days. And finally yesterday, I got a call saying they've been able to source the brake pad and that I can pick it up today. So therefore, we are en route to the Tuscarawas dealer to pick up the fat boy. In the interim, I've been doing some rides on the Himalayan. So I did a ride to Ambur, to Rehmania, Priyani Hotel. If you haven't caught that yet, and if that video is already released, I'm going to place a link here. And plus I also did a couple of city rides on the Himalayan. So yes, so while the fat boy was in the shop, I made sure that I did a fair bit of riding on the Himalayan. So when I say a fair bit, that's completely relative because I don't really use the Himalayan much. Because the fat boy was at the shop, I got the opportunity to ride the Himalayan. Well, here we are at the Harley showroom, looking forward to getting the fat boy. And the one thing that happened today is in the excitement to get my motorcycle, I got my helmet all right, but forgot my riding jacket and my gloves. So I think this will be the first time that I'll be riding without my riding jacket and gloves. Well, anyways, we'll say a prayer and ride. Hopefully everything will be fine.
There she is.
How are you guys doing?
Good job.
After 2000 kilometers, you have to replace this front brake pad.
Rear brake pad, you
mean? Rear brake pad, sir.
2000 kilometers is still maybe a couple of months, so.
Okay.
So, did you ride the motorcycle?
Yes.
Oh, it's fine.
The engine oil, airbox oil has been replaced on the motorcycle. The oil filter has been replaced. Brake pad, front brake pad is replaced.
Front brake pad.
Yes.
So, engine oil, clutch oil?
Gearbox oil.
Gearbox oil. And the
all
servicing?
Three, the complete servicing. All nuts and bolts have been retorqued. All cables have been lubricated.
Okay.
And the programming of the bike has been done.
programming, and that light thing is also sorted.
Yes.
What was the issue with that?
The connector was the issue. When the connector terminal below the tank.
Yeah. So it's fine now.
It's fine.
No issues. So it's what, 18,000?
956.
18,956. So now for the next
10,000 kilometers.
10,000 kilometers. No problem. No problem. Only after 2,000 kilometers I need to change my rear. Is there any physical thing where I'll be able to find out that?
I'll just show you how.
Huh?
Yeah.
And when you brake, will it kind of create some sort of a?
There will be metal sound.
Metal sound. See you guys.
Can you see those brake pads in between the rotor?
Brake pad in between the rotor.
The disc.
I can see the disc. In between that, I can see that.
There is two layers. One is metal, one is ceramic one.
One is metal, one is ceramic.
Yeah. That ceramic one, once that gets worn out completely, you have to replace the brake pad.
Okay, but I can only see one. Two are there right now.
Yeah, the
back
side there will be one more.
Oh, okay. So that will, that thin layer that I see, that will not be there.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Or else if you see any scoring marks here.
Any scoring marks?
Yeah, on the disc.
Oh.
That is good.
Because then it's cutting into the metal layer. Fantastic. Oh, now it's perfect. Nice. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
I'll see you around. That's Hemant, the chief service manager here at Harley Davidson. So thanks to him, I was able to actually ride out on my Fat Boy. He sourced the brake pads from Hyderabad.
Hyderabad.
Fantastic. Thank you very much, buddy.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Happy to get my Fat Boy back. Everything looks nice, pick and span. My turn lights are working. It's been a challenge for a long time. My first ride where I'm not wearing my riding jacket. I'm gonna say a prayer and then start. So I've done 37,197 kilometers. So my next service will be at 47,000. But of course I'll need to bring in the motorcycle in a couple of thousand kilometers to change the rear brake pads. Oh, the engine feels so smooth. So smooth. It's a weird feeling to be holding the handle without my gloves. The motorcycle feels super smooth. Thank you, Tusker Harley, for a great job on the servicing and more specifically for sourcing that front brake pad. You know, they could have very easily said we don't have it in stock. We'll call you when our shipment comes in, because they were expecting their container to come in about a month's time. But I requested them and then they sourced it from the Harley dealership. They checked on where the brake pad was available. I know they connected with Delhi, Bombay, but they found it in Hyderabad and they shipped it here for me. So looking at the bill today, some of you might wonder, does it cost 20,000 rupees each time I send the motorcycle for servicing? Well, the answer to that is no. Servicing is 7,500 rupees, or roughly about 9,000 or 10,000 rupees, I think, including GST, etc. And that's something that you do every 7,500-10,000 kilometers. And then of course you have the consumables that get charged. And this time around, I also had, in addition to the gear oil, the engine oil, etc., I also had the brake pads, and that's the reason why my bill was about 19,000 rupees. But for a typical servicing, I think it's around, I think I've spent 10-11,000 rupees. I think off late is about once a year. That's the sort of money that you pay to service the motorcycle. I mean, touch wood, I've hardly had any issues on this motorcycle. I've done about 37,000 kilometers on it thus far. You know, that's the thing with these motorcycles, they're built to last. They're built to last, whether it's the engine, the components, the parts. That's the reason why you pay top dollar for these motorcycles. Oh, the braking has become, it's stopping on a dime now. Wow. Riding without my gloves, I feel, feels weird. Apart from the protection that it provides, it's just so used to having that glove, that leather. I think I should have one of my old gloves in the motorcycle. I don't know, I'll probably check ahead. Let me try and see if I can find an old pair of gloves that should be here somewhere. Let me see if I can find it. If I find it, it'll be a bonus. Ah, there it is. A very old pair. This is, I think, my first pair of gloves. When you're just beginning riding out, you don't really buy expensive stuff. So this, I think, is a Cramster. And this is my first pair of gloves. I probably had, I'm on my third or fourth pair now. But, you know, I don't like to throw things. I said, okay, let me just chuck it there just in case of an emergency or something of that sort. And well, today is that day to use this finally. So I never really throw stuff. I always find a use case scenario for it, and well, oh, this seems to have shrunk.
You asking something?
Sorry?
Were you asking me something?
No, I'm talking to the camera.
Big one?
I said that's a sweet motorcycle.
Thank you. Nothing to be here.
My second motorcycle is a Himalayan.
Okay. Kripal Amana?
Yes, I'm Kripal Amana.
I'm a fan of yours.
Oh, nice to meet you. We can shake hands. What's your name?
My name is David Saldana. I'm very silent, but I follow quite a lot of your work.
Ah, okay. David Saldana.
Yeah, yeah.
Are you from Bengaluru?
Mangaluru.
I was born in Mangalore.
I know. I figured that out from your show.
Oh, okay. Nice.
So I'm going to catch up with you. Nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you too. Always nice to connect with fans of the show, and especially if they happen to be motorcyclists too. I've got my gloves sorted. Let's go. Ah, feels so good. You know, once you get used to wearing these gloves and riding, without gloves, it just seems like an effort to actually work the clutch, work the brake. The clutch also feels nice and smooth. They've changed the oils. The Harley gears have a clunk. And that clunk sounds very crisp now because they've changed the gear oil. I'm so happy to be reunited with a fat boy after 10 days. So there's a slot in my parking bay where the fat boy sits. And so I would see that every day. Empty. Not a good feeling at all. Of course, I had the Himalayan right next to it for company, and the motorcycle that I rode a fair bit the last 10 days. But still, you know, just the fact that you know your fat boy is in the garage somewhere waiting for parts, not a good feeling. But I'm so happy and so thankful to Tusker Harley, to Hemant. Big thumbs up to Tusker Harley for sourcing this part for me. And this was my first experience of Harley Davidson after this exit. And I must say, it's been fantastic. Of course, it took some time for them to locate the part, but just the manner in which they helped me out is just super awesome. So for those who ask me, does it make a difference? Well, you just saw what happened. I got my servicing done, everything done, absolutely spot on. I needed a part which they did not have in stock. They sourced it for me. So as a motorcyclist, as a rider, as a Harley Davidson owner, there's really no difference. There's really no difference. And now that Hero has come in, which is a much larger organization with their own setup, I'm sure everything will be great. And the one thing that I'm looking forward to when it comes to the Harley is the Pan America, that adventure motorcycle. I'm sure many of you have seen videos on YouTube. That motorcycle looks quite striking. It's a game changer, I think, for Harley Davidson in terms of what they've achieved with that motorcycle, at least from whatever one has seen in the videos. I can't wait for that motorcycle to hit India. And from my conversation that I had with the dealer, I think they may price it at a sweet spot. It
could be a game changer. Hopefully you see a lot more Harleys on the road. I think it'll also kind of add to the whole image, right?
And it will be a volume runner, and this year's only launch.
This year's only launch. Yeah, you mentioned you were training on the... You said there has to be a certain score, only then will dealers be allowed to sell the Pan America. So good, they're creating a lot of excitement around the product. So it'll be what, price around what the GS 1250 is at? Or maybe lesser or higher? Yeah? It'll be a speed price if the Pan America is at that price. And it's got that adaptive height and all that, right? When the motorcycle comes to a stop, it lowers down and stuff. Looks very interesting.
If they get the pricing right of that motorcycle, I think it will be a game changer. I think the Pan America will be a motorcycle, will be the motorcycle to watch, to look out for. When you talk about the Harley Davidson brand, I think there's a certain appeal of that brand. A lot of people have seen the brand growing up. There's an aspirational appeal to the brand. Of course, you know, people want a little more capability from the motorcycle. They want to go off-roading that once in a while and things like that. A motorcycle that can probably do more than cruising. And I guess that's where the Pan America fits in. So it's got a great brand, great product, and if they get the pricing right, that will definitely be a motorcycle that will shake up the premium adventure market here in India. And I'm sure the rest of the world too. These are probably the cheapest gloves that I have. I don't even remember what I paid for it, but I'm sure not much. But it's almost a lifesaver in a situation like this. So sometimes it's not about the most expensive gear that you can find. It's what you have at that point in time. Many a times we look to things that we don't have, things that we aspire to, that we look down upon, that we overlook what we have. But then, however insignificant it may seem, the smallest of things too can be a lifesaver, like this love from 5 years ago. I'm going to stop by at the sweet shop and see if they have some mishti dohi, some sweet curd. The boss likes it. She doesn't know that I'm getting some, but just surprise her a bit with the mishti dohi. Bancha Rams. I love their mishti dohi. मिष्टी दोई है कुल्हड़ में देना, छोटा कुल्हड़ देना मेरे को, आठ देना, आठ नॉलेन कोर चार देना. दैट लुक्स एब्सोल्युटली गुड एंड सो डज दैट द नॉलेन कोर, द मिष्टी दोई एंड द नॉलेन कोर रसगुल्ला. नो राइडिंग जैकेट टुडे, आई ओनली हैव माय हेलमेट एंड माय ग्लव्स. दो सिंगाड़ा भी डाल देना, स्पॉटेड सम सिंगाड़ा, थॉट आई विल टेस्ट सम टू. This is one of my favorite sweet shops, Bancha Rams. They make the best mishti dohi, and you should buy them in that kullad, the curd that is set in that kullad, because I think that's the best. This is another dessert to try here. This is the baby rasgulla with the rabdi on top, and then I think they caramelize the top of it. Delicious. Loaded though in calories.
Well, I'm back home. The GoPro battery died at Bancha Rams, from where I've got some of this mishti dohi. So I just thought I'd close the video at home. Just for those of you who may want a detailed breakdown of the bill, the oil filter has been replaced, the engine oil, the gasket service kit, the gasket clutch cover, the brake pad kit, the servicing, the consumables, the washing, and the brake pads that were replaced. So all in all, my bill was 18,956, and this includes the GST, etc. So for the parts I paid 9,700, for labor 6,000, and that's what the service was all about. But I'm so happy that I've got the fat boy back, and now it's time to get to that mishti dohi. Oh, I just love this, the mishti dohi in the kullad, the earthen pot. If you haven't tried the Bancha Rams mishti dohi, you definitely must try it. That yogurt, that sweet yogurt, has a texture of velvet. The moment you place it in your mouth, it dissolves away. It has a slight caramelized sort of a tone. Oh, that's just delicious. And I love that creamy skin that the dahi makes on top as it is set in this earthen pot. If you love your yogurt, definitely get one of these mishti dohis from Bancha Rams. So anyways, that's it for this vlog on the Harley Davidson Fat Boy service. Also, I guess you got a perspective on the road ahead for Harley Davidson here in India and how things change, or actually don't really change much for Harley Davidson owners. I hope you found this vlog interesting, informative. If you did, give it a big thumbs up. If you like this vlog, do like and share. If you haven't subscribed yet, do consider subscribing to the second channel, the Kripalamana channel. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye. I'm going to go back to my mishti dohi. That's just the right amount of sweetness. Not too much, not too less. Love it.